requesting all of you, please kindly mute yourself. Mute yourself. Okay, so total how many members has joined the meeting now? So should we start? हेलो हेलो
यस सर
सो शुड वी स्टार्ट नाउ ओनली 31 पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर देयर
यस सर यस सर
यस सर
यस
म्यूट योर सेल्फ आई एम स्टार्टिंग ओके इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी प्रॉब्लम देन please comment on the chat box. Okay, so very good morning to all of you. Okay, so today we are going to start the atomic structure. So the first chapter of inorganic chemistry, the atomic structure is generally the word, it is a combination of two words. First is atom having the so atomic structure. First we will look to the history of the atom. In case of structure of atom, very first scientist Democritus developed the idea of atoms. In the year 460 BC, he found that a material which is heavy, he kept the material in the pestle and mortar, and he reduced them to a very smallest and smaller particle, which he called as atom. See, in the simple way, if we take the one chalk piece, and after taking that chalk piece, if we break this chalk piece into number of pieces, first it will break into two parts, then four, then eight, then 16, like this. So one stage will come when there is possibility that under that circumstances, further division is not possible. Means at one stage will come when there is no possibility of further division. So atom is a combination of two words, A and tom. It is having the two words. So just I am showing here. It is combination of two words, A, which means absent, and another is tom. So tom is nothing but division. So this is the combination of two words, A, and another is tom. Can you look that word document properly?
Yes, sir.
This what document? Here I am showing you. It is combination of two words. That is A for absent. Tom means division. So when there is no possibility of further division, that stage is called atom. It is the Greek word. So atom is the combination of two words. When there is no possibility of further division, that stage is called the atom. अगर हमने एक चौक पीस लिया उसको नंबर ऑफ पीसेस करते गए और ब्रेक किए एक स्टेज ऐसी आएंगी तो तब फर्दर डिवीजन पॉसिबल नहीं रहेगा. वो जो पार्टिकल लास्ट में जो पार्टिकल मिलेगा वो पार्टिकल रहेगा एटम जिसकी फर्दर डिवीजन पॉसिबल नहीं. दिस इज नोन एज एटम. नाउ सेकंड इज द हाउ द एटम हैज बीन डिस्कवर्ड. व्हाट इज द कांसेप्ट. हाउ मेनी साइंटिस्ट हैज कंट्रीब्यूटेड फॉर एटम. So first history of atom. In the year 1808, John Dalton has suggested that all the matter was made up of tiny spheres or tiny particle, and he called these tiny particle which are bonded to each other by means of elastic nature. These particles he called is as an atom. Next scientist who proposed the concept of atom is Thomson. According to Thomson concept, he found that inside the atom some negative particles are also there. He called these negative particles as electrons. So Joseph and John Thomson has given this concept in the year 1898. Next, according to Thomson, he found that these negative particles, he called them as a electron, and he proposed the model of electron. According to Thomson model, he developed that an idea that atom was made up of electron which are surrounded on all the space of an atom, and positive charge or positive particles are also there. He pronounced that these electrons are having balanced with the positive parts. So this positive part which you are looking here, which is having some background space here, can you see this positive part, positive sign?
Yes,
hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Am I audible now clearly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
आपको
yes, sir.
आ रही?
Yes.
Everything is okay now. So, इसमें जो आपको जो सर्कल नजर आ रहा है एटम का, इसके बैक साइड में देखिए आप. So, ये जो पॉजिटिव साइन है, दिस पॉजिटिव साइन इज नथिंग बट दिस द पॉजिटिव पार्टिकल. इन दैट पॉजिटिव पार्टिकल ही परफॉर्म दैट दिस स्पॉट्स व्हिच आर इन येलो इन कलर हियर, ही कॉल्ड दिस स्पॉट्स एज इलेक्ट्रॉन, एंड दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर बैलेंस्ड विद दिस पॉजिटिव साइन. सो नंबर ऑफ पॉजिटिव साइन्स आर देयर, ही कॉल्ड दिस पॉजिटिव साइन एज अ पॉजिटिव पार्टिकल्स. इन दैट पॉजिटिव चार्ज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर बैलेंस्ड. Next is, he called this model as a plum pudding model. अगर आपने केक देखे होंगे, केक के ऊपर इस तरह से एक आइसक्रीम की एक लेयर रहती है और उसमें जो रहते हैं चेरीज जो डालते हैं या दूसरे पार्टिकल जो डालते हैं, इन द सेम मैनर ही कॉल्ड दिस मॉडल एज अ प्लम पुडिंग मॉडल. ओके, हैव यू सीन द केक? हेलो.
यस सर.
On the cake, what happened? Some creams are there, whipped creams like that. On that whipped cream, what you observed? Some cherries are there, some other particles are there, some dry fruits are there. In the similar way, this whole cream is consist of the positive atmosphere. On that positive atmosphere, so these cherries and dry fruits are behaving as a negative electron. So this model, he gives the name as a plum pudding model. Next is, next scientist who has given a concept and very clear concept of the atom or structure of atom is the Ernest Rutherford. In the year 1910, he found that he performed one experiment. He oversaw Zeiser and Marson famous experiment. They fired the helium nuclei at a piece of gold foil. So what he performed? उसने क्या किया, गोल्ड फॉइल लिया और गोल्ड फॉइल के ऊपर क्या किया, हीलियम के बम्बार्डमेंट किया, हीलियम पार्टिकल और हीलियम न्यूक्लियस। उसने ये ऑब्जर्व किया, आफ्टर बम्बार्डिंग द हीलियम न्यूक्लियाई एट अ पीस ऑफ गोल्ड फॉइल, ही फाउंड दैट मोस्ट ऑफ देम पास थ्रू दिस गोल्ड फॉइल एंड सम आर कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम दैट गोल्ड फॉइल। सो ही gold foil by means of this nuclei, helium nuclei, and we know that helium nuclei consists of atomic number 2 and atomic number 4. So how he performed this experiment, this is the just I will so this is the helium, this is the gold foil which I have take which I have show you by means of this pink circle. Okay, this is the gold foil, and these are the, he bombarded this gold foil by means of helium nuclei. So here these are the helium nuclei. After bombarding, what happened? Some of the helium nuclei are coming out. So this I am showing you. Okay, these helium nuclei are coming out from this exit. Okay, now they found that most of the helium nuclei passed, which are attracted by this gold foil. And number of small were deflected, some are deflecting, these are the black arrows which are coming off, so these are the deflecting, and some nuclei are bounced straight back. So on that basis, what happened, he come to conclusion that so according to Rutherford's model, he developed the idea that the atoms consist of central part which is having positive charge. He called this central part as a nucleus. Okay, this is the central nucleus. Now he suggested that positive charge was all in the central nucleus, which is around the central nucleus electrons are revolving. So here, according to Rutherford model, just I will show here how this will work. So according to Rutherford model, the central part is known as nucleus, which is positive charge. Around the nucleus, electrons are revolving. So there is attraction between the central part and the revolving electron. Now, next scientist is the Neil Bohr, who has given the concept in the year 1913. According to Neil Bohr, was studying under the Rutherford. So he took the concept of Rutherford and proceed ahead. Okay, he has developed the one model according to Rutherford. The central part of the atom is positive charge, and around this positive charge central part, which is called as a nucleus, around this the electrons are revolving in a space or in the particular energy level. So according to Neil Bohr, he performed the experiment. The electrons which are revolving around the nucleus are having the electrostatic force between nucleus, which is having positive charge, and the negatively charged electron. So specific electron is revolving. So just look here. I will show you the model of an electron. So here, suppose it is the central part. Okay, can you see the properly? No. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Everything is okay now?
Yes, sir.
So this blue, this blue circle, which I have considered as a nucleus, so it will be the structure of atom. So I will show you here by taking the color. Now here this. So here, this circle, which I have taken the small circle, it is having the, suppose it is red color. So this red color circle is nothing but what? It is the nucleus. This nucleus is consist of which charge particle? Positively charged particle. Around this nucleus, electrons are revolving. So this is the space where the electrons are revolving. So this is the first energy level. Now if we took again one more circle, suppose here around this one. So this is the this will be the another circle according to Neil Bohr. Okay. Now this is the central part is the nucleus. Around the nucleus electrons are revolving. Now we'll go for our concept. So he proposed that the energy level where the electrons are revolving, this energy level he called as orbits. Here I have shown you in the orange mark. Let us see what he given the concept that energy level orbits. So similar to the concept of planet and sun model. What is the planet model? The planets are revolving around the sun. Okay, similar to moon is revolving, earth is revolving, and other planets are also revolving around the earth, sorry, around the sun. So sun is considered as a nucleus, and around the nucleus, just here, suppose here this orange nucleus is considered as a sun, and these are the planets which are revolving here. So he given the concept of planet model. Neil Bohr has given the concept of planet model similar applicable to the structure of atom. So central part is the nucleus. Around the nucleus, electrons are revolving. So nucleus is considered, he considered nucleus as a sun, and around the sun, these planets which are revolving as considered as an electron. So these are the structure. Bohr's model of atom. Electrons in the orbits are behaving just they are revolving around the sun, okay, around the nucleus. So nucleus is positive charged particle and electrons are negatively charged particle. These are revolving around the nucleus. Next is a clear structure of nucleus. Here we can understand. So here it is the central part. It is consists of positively charged particle. So these are what? This is the central part. This is the central part which I am showing you. This central part is consists of what? Neutron and proton. So protons are the positively charged particles. Okay. Now, these are the central part, or central part is consists of proton and neutron. And around the neutron in a specific orbit, this is the space between the orbit and this nucleus. This orbit is considered as a shell. Or energy level. In that energy level, these electrons are revolving. So it is the first energy level, electrons are revolving. Here it will be the second energy level. Okay, and here it will be the third energy level. Electrons are revolving in the particular space or particular energy level. Okay. So what these particles are consist of? Okay, what will be the shape? What will be the mass of that particle? What will be the charge on that particle? It given the concept of this particle one by one. Next thing, is not working properly. Now, after that, now the atomic structure is consist of how many particles? The central part is consist of proton and neutron. So here the central part of the atom is the nucleus having the proton. And what is the charge on that proton? Positive. What is mass? 1. Neutron
one.
Is no charge and it no is charge. Mass 1. Electron is what? Negatively charged particle. Yes, anybody is having any problem?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay, everything is...
No, sir.
Okay. Now, the atomic structures consist of how many species, how many particles? 3 particles. So, proton is the positive charge particle having mass 1, which is present inside the nucleus. Neutron is having no charge, having mass 1, which is also present in the nucleus. And electron is negatively charged particle which is having negligible mass, that is E. And electron is revolving around the nucleus. So here we will show here, it is this orange part is the nucleus. Around the nucleus, electrons are revolving. So here, the proton and neutron are present inside this orange nucleus. Here I am showing by color, orange color. Now we will go for next. Now the atomic structure, how should we should represent the atomic structure? So if we took the helium, the atomic number of helium is 2 and atomic mass is 4. So what is meaning of atomic number? Number of proton in an atom is known as atomic number. What is the definition of atomic number? Yes, any
4.
What will be the definition of atomic number? Yes. What is the definition of atomic number? The number of protons
present in an atom.
Atomic number. What is the atomic mass? The number of proton and neutron in an atom is known as atomic mass. Okay. So here, the atomic number is nothing but what? Total number of proton. And proton are present inside the nucleus. Okay. So atomic number always equals to number of electron. Electrons are present around the what? Electrons are present around the nucleus. So these are the orange particles which are revolving. These are the electrons. And these positive charge particles are what? Protons. These are considered as, or these are called as protons. Around the protons or around the nucleus, electrons are revolving. So total number of total number of proton is nothing but atomic numbers. How many protons are there here in this slide? 2 protons. How many protons?
2 protons.
2 protons. So these are the positively charged particles. These are the 2 protons. And these protons are nothing but atomic number. So what is the definition of atomic number? Number of proton in an atom is known as atomic number. Okay. So I will just do here. I will erase it. Okay. So atomic number is denoted by Z. Okay, here it is not indicating, but atomic number is denoted by Z. What will be the notation for atomic number? Z. Z is the notation for atomic number. And capital A is the notation for atomic mass. Okay, atomic mass is denoted by capital A. So what is atomic mass? Sum of proton and neutron, or total number of proton and neutron in an atom is known as atomic mass. Generally, what happens? The atomic number is represented on the base and atomic mass is represented on the head. Okay. Here it is having some just I will show here how it should be represented. If we look this helium. So here it is the helium having atomic number 2 and atomic mass is 4. So here this atomic number 2 should be represented like this. Here is this now. And atomic mass should be represented like this, okay? So can you see it properly? This 2, which is represented on the base of helium, okay, which I will show by means of red color, and atomic mass by means of some other color, and also in green color, or yellow. So how the atomic number and atomic mass should be shown? Can you see properly? Yes? Anybody? Hello.
Yes, sir.
So, how the atomic number should be shown? This is the helium atom. The atomic number is shown on the base of that helium atom. Okay. Helium atom कहाँ बताएंगे आप? ये sorry. Atomic number कहाँ बताएंगे? Helium के base में और mass कहाँ बताएंगे? Helium के head पर. So this is the correct representation of atomic number and atomic mass. Okay. So now we will go for our main topic. So here atomic number is represented total number of proton in an atom. Atomic mass represent the number of proton and neutron in an atom. Okay. So number of electron always equal to number of proton. So proton मतलब क्या है बोलो? Positively charged particle inside the nucleus. ये न्यूक्लियस है.